Yes, MDXLR. We have something to tell you, MD. This is a commentary intervention. We're both going to say a few things, and then we'll have our final words to say. MTR, you starred.
MD, when I first saw your commentaries, I've noticed something who had a passion for making commentaries. But then, after watching your videos over and over again, as well as seeing other commentators doing commentaries on you and debunking your other points, I can't do it anymore. OMD.
Well, what I want to do instead of telling him I feel like we should make a commentary on one of your recent videos. And that will be a triple feature of Review Tech USA.
Okay, before we start, I do want to get this disclaimer out of the...
Hey! Where's your intro statement?
My name is A363MTR, and I'm here to kick some ass because I got your back. There. Happy?
Yes.
Fucking Trump. Anyways, I want to make a disclaimer towards MDXLR videos. Before you get on our case by me doing the commentary on you... I don't hate you. In fact, we're not going to be making fun of you. After when you watch this commentary, I still want to be friends with you, and hopefully we could possibly laugh and move on in the near future.
However, we don't think that the commentary that you've done on Review Tech USA was great, so we're basically going to do a commentary on it. I mean, I honestly can't get as to where you're coming from with the commentary, but the points that you've brought up didn't hold up much weight.
Okay, so here's how we're gonna do this. We're gonna do his Black Ops 3 video first, and then his Fallout 4 one, and I'm doing both in the same bid because both videos are related in a way that'll become quite clear as we advance on.
And there's your first problem. It would have been better if you have done a commentary on only one of the 360/PS rant, then proceed on with the Uncharted video. Yeah, she lied to us. It's actually a triple feature.
Anyways, it still would have been a double feature either way. Your commentating on two of the same videos, only except with somewhat different topics, is kind of pointless. I mean, you did repeat some of the same points when commentating on those videos.
Activision, you need a lot of prunes, and you need a lot of laxatives. You know why? Because you're so full of shit that you're gonna explode! They're going into the whole thing of how, oh, we promise it's actually going to utilize the Xbox One, PS4, and PC to their full potential. But you're full of crap. I don't want to hear that you're going to whittle away at Black Ops 3 to make the 7th gen versions, because you have to keep the 7th gen versions in mind the entire time to make the game work at all for the consoles.
No. No, they don't. You stated earlier that there were separate developers for the 7th gen version, apart from the 8th gen version. Either that, or you are really bad at wording, and if that's the case, then you might want to have someone proofread your script, and if this isn't even scripted, then you've done something wrong.
Really? Really? Oh, God. Okay. So, Call of Duty Black Ops 3. We knew it was coming. It's coming to the Xbox One, PS4, and PC. But even better news! It's also coming to the PS3 and Xbox 360. It's going to be developed by the Spider-Man series developer Beenox and Mercenary Technology. Now, of course, Activision went into full damage control and said that Black Ops 3 is going to be designed to harness the full potential of the Xbox One, PS4, and PC. And the last-gen developers will be working backwards rather than the other way around.
Well, yeah, there were two different groups of developers that do make the games on two different console generations, but the developers don't decide as to whether or not if they should make the game on the previous gen console. It's usually someone higher up, like the producer or the publisher of the games, or the owner of the company.
Let these 7th gen consoles go. Virtually every other developer out there is saying, you know what, it's time to let the 360 and PS3 go. They've had a hell of a run. It was like the longest main generation ever. Keyword is main generation. I know there's been other consoles like the PS2, excuse me, was supported from 2000 to 2013. But the 360 and PS3, they were the top dog from 2005 to 2013. That's a long-ass generation.
Okay, so one, the PS2 was part of the main generation of consoles. Granted, the last Xbox game was in 2008, GameCube in 2007, while the PS2 was all the way forward in 2013, like you said. But the thing is, going by your logic, excluding the PS2 from the main generation, we'd have to exclude the 360 and PS3 because they outlived the Wii, which was also part of the main generation. The logic just doesn't work the way you're saying it does. And two, just because the 8th gen is starting doesn't mean we should all just drop the 7th gen, burn all the 360s, PS3s, and Wiis, and say, all hail the next gen, all hail the next gen, all hail the next gen, and I really need to work on my acting.
Well, to be fair, and you did mention this before, the GameCube did end in 2007. In fact, a couple of months shortly after the release of the Wii. That and the Xbox did start to slowly decline sales after the release of the 360, so I can kinda see where Rish is coming from. True, as he mentioned, the PS2 lasted for a good 13 years, in fact even 2 months before the release of the PS4, but ever since the announcement of the 360 and Wii, the Xbox and GameCube were going down to the bottom of the bin.
We know your home skips, pick up the phone skips, we know your home skips, pick up the phone skips.
Alright! This game is not going to be Call of Duty Black Ops 3, due to the fact that it's coming out for 7th gen consoles at all, is not going to take full advantage of the PS4, Xbox One, and PC. Just the fact that you're coming out with the game for the 7th gen consoles proves that. So you could say whatever you want to, you could damage control any way you want to, we all know you're lying. Because the only way you could take advantage of the next gen consoles is not having a half-assed game come out for the 7th gen. It's fact, it's common sense.
Not entirely. It could be possible, especially if you have two separate teams working on the games.
Actually, there could be limitations on what you could do on the 7th gen console than on the 8th gen console. The 7th gen console don't really have the advanced equipment anymore to make better games because of how the gaming developers want the games to be in HD. Now, I'm not saying that there weren't HD games from PS3 and Xbox 360, but they weren't released in HD when the consoles first came out. In fact, they actually released some of the old games as a separate file of the games, like how the 360 did on the Xbox originals when they released the original Xbox games. Same thing with the PS3 when they did with the PS1 games. Now, someone would complain, oh, but it's just graphics, this really isn't the issue here. But you do need to keep in mind that most consumers and gaming developers nowadays want the best looking picture and the smoothest frame per second on today's games.
We know your home skips, pick up the phone skips, we know your home skips, pick up the phone skips.
Alright! So if you haven't noticed, which I'm sure if you even have a slight interest in gaming and you're watching my channel, you have. Everyone's talking about Fallout 4. Bethesda officially announced it and people are losing their minds over it. Well, on NeoGAF, Matt Grandstaff, Bethesda's community lead, made a very big announcement. Fallout 4 will not be coming to the PS3 and 360. He said, and I quote, "The stuff we're doing will never work there." I can't believe we're still even talking about the Xbox 360 and PS3.
You fucking what, mate?
Why is that? This isn't the first time a console from a previous gen lived to see the next. I mean, look at the PS2, an example you brought up in the video you made right before this one.
He was saying that people are still talking about the issues of the PS3 360 to this day, not by saying that the idea of keeping 7th gen consoles was not new.
We know your home skips, pick up the phone skips, we know your home skips, pick up the phone skips.
Alright! And I know everyone's gonna get at me, Rich, I thought you weren't a fan of Fallout 4. Yeah, I'm not. What's the big fucking deal? But I could still commend Bethesda for making a smart decision. What's the big deal? Just because I'm not a fan of the series doesn't mean I can't compliment a company on making a good choice.
That is exactly what it means there, Captain Small Erection. You said you hated the Fallout series, so you can't compliment Bethesda ever!
What the? When did I ever say I hated the Fallout series?
Is this referencing something? Oh yeah, you made that Fallout 4 video about how it's okay not to be excited for it. And since I haven't seen that video, we're just gonna end this video here.
Honey, you're killing me. Okay, I can understand on whether or not if you should skip some things, such as not watching a TV show or playing a game or whatnot within your own commentaries, MD. But this is sadly not really acceptable, considering that you decide to not watch a 7 minute and 38 second video! Yeah, I've seen the video about how it's okay to not get excited about the release of Fallout 4, and he was restating his point in the video that you're commentating on, hell, even stating that he doesn't even hate the series altogether. However, the fact that you're saying that you wouldn't want to watch the small time frame video within your own commentary, it just somewhat proves how lazy you can be, especially since in the very near future, you could possibly try to debunk someone's points in the small time frame video too.
We know your home skips, pick up the phone skips, we know your home skips, pick up the phone skips,
alright!
As many of you may know, Sony is releasing the Nathan Drake Collection for the PlayStation 4. It's going to release all three games that were originally for the PlayStation 3, Drake's Fortune, Among Thieves, and Drake's Deception. Now, of course, this is a remastered collection, so it's going to have all the shit that you would expect. It's going to have better graphics, 1080p, 60 frames per second, a new photo mode, and additional trophy support. Just, it's typical fare for the whole remastered craze that's going on with the 8th gen consoles, and it even was going on later in the 7th generation of consoles, too. But you're probably thinking, okay, Rich, yeah, all right, it's another remastered collection. We've seen it a billion times before, but at least we'll get to play the multiplayer.
You fucking what, mate?
Maybe it's just the circles I frequented, but from what I've gathered, almost nobody really cares about the multiplayer for Uncharted. I'm not saying there isn't an audience for that.
Which is why you said almost nobody cares about the multiplayer in Uncharted. True, you said almost nobody, but it's rather poor wording.
But what I'm getting at here is that it's not the most crucial thing ever, and it's not like a game-breaking, sale-breaking, deal-breaking kind of thing. It's not like if a Halo collection came out and there was no multiplayer for that, because Halo actually is an online-based community, where Uncharted fans usually want to play the story of Nathan Drake, and maybe toy with the multiplayer afterwards.
The same thing can apply with the Halo series as well. Most people can play the game to find out what happens in story mode, then later try the multiplayer. Also, I have played Uncharted 2, and I remember playing the multiplayer where there were a huge audience playing with me.
Of the Uncharted series that was good with Among Thieves, I didn't like it in Drake's Deception. People disagree with me. There's people who actually prefer the multiplayer in Drake's Deception, but, you know, potato, potato, it's your opinion. Well, I got some bad news for you. The only multiplayer you're going to get with the Uncharted, the Nathan Drake Collection, is the beta multiplayer for Uncharted 4. You heard me right, folks. The Nathan Drake Collection is not going to include the excellent multiplayer from Among Thieves or from Drake's Deception. You are shit out of luck. It is the single-player campaign for all three games only.
Why does it matter? From what I've seen, Uncharted 2 and 3's multiplayers were pretty similar to each other, gameplay-wise anyway. Well, so are the games as a whole, but still. And it's not like you aren't getting a multiplayer at all. You yourself have stated in this video that you're getting the Uncharted 4 beta multiplayer, which means you're still getting a multiplayer. And it kind of defeats the purpose of them adding 2 and 3's multiplayer, because then you'd have three separate multiplayers that play pretty freaking similar to each other.
Actually, it does somewhat matter, because there can be someone, like me, who haven't even played most, if not then all of the games that either will be remastered or that had been remastered before. Yeah, I'm sorry, I suck at being a good gamer. And we would know as to what it would look like if we were to play the game again with all of the functions within the games to be in the remastered version, with the only exception of the upgraded graphics. In fact, there could be even fans out there, and not just the diehard ones, who would want to have the functions in the game as well.
Also, if Uncharted 2's, 3's, and 4's multiplayer are similar to each other, then what is the main point of adding in the multiplayer beta for Uncharted 4 and removing the multiplayer for 2 and 3? Why not make the beta for Uncharted 4 separate for PlayStation Plus members, kind of like how they did when Uncharted 3 did the multiplayer beta?
First off, to Sony and Microsoft, why do you, like, brag and boast that your remastered games from the previous generation of consoles can run at 1080p 60 frames per second on your 8th gen or next gen consoles? Duh! They better be able to do it! It's supposed to be more powerful hardware! Like, no offense, Sony, if you couldn't get three games from the previous generation of consoles to run at 1080p 60 frames per second on your next-gen console, there'd be some big fucking problems. I mean, for Christ's sake, the consoles are underpowered enough to begin with. If you couldn't get games from the previous generation to run at full 1080p, 60 frames per second, that would be bad.
That's why they brag about it. They brag that, oh, look at The Last of Us, that was an awesome game, it looked gorgeous, it played heavenly. And now look at the PS4 version, it looks even better, it plays even better. It's like someone pointing you at a toaster and saying, while your toaster can simply toast toast, this toaster can toast toast and hot dogs. And that was unfunny.
Here's a tip for you then. If you think that the joke is not funny, which, by the way, don't state that it's not funny unless if you have another joke to state that it wasn't funny at all, then play around with the joke. Try to find ways where the joke would be funny to not only you, but to the audience as well. But for now, I'm giving you an F. See me after class, because your overall grade in Comedy Fundamentals 1-1 is terrible.
We know your home skips, pick up the phone skips, we know your home skips, pick up the phone skips.
Alright! We want to get this game out for the holidays, we want to give another game to entice people to buy more PlayStation, people, or consumers, I should say, to buy more PlayStation 4s. People know Uncharted, it's a well-known first-party franchise from us, we don't really have that much else to offer.
Yes, because Sony, the company with exclusive franchises like Ratchet & Clank, Infamous, Sly Cooper, God of War, Little Big Planet, Persona, and so on, with upcoming games like Persona 5, Until Dawn, No Man's Sky, Amplitude, Mighty No. 9...
Wait, Mighty No. 9 is a PS4 exclusive? Then explain why it's also coming out for the PS3, 360, Xbone, Wii U, 3DS, Vita, PC, Mac, and Linux. It's pretty much fucking far from being an exclusive. Same thing can apply to No Man's Sky, which is also coming out on PC as well. Yeah, the PS4 is the only console to get this game, but with it on PC as well, it's not really an exclusive either.
We know your home skips, pick up the phone skips, we know your home skips, pick up the phone skips.
Alright! I feel like this is what all this 8th gen is going to be about. It's just remasters of old fucking games.
Okay, so it's only been 3 years since the 8th gen began, but we can already judge it and say the entire year is going to be nothing but HD remasters and ports, because, you know, 3 years is enough time to dictate what an entire generation of consoles is going to be like. Yeah, totally. That's totally not the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life.
He wasn't saying that all of the files that would be released would be a remaster. He was saying that the majority of the games released this year would be a remaster. Yeah, he said all, but he did somewhat say it's all it is going to be about, like as if the remaster ones are going to be the important games to look out for. You seriously need to listen and understand words better than what you already can.
And that's the end of the commentary. MTR, you state your final thoughts first.
Unlike many of the other people who are commentating on you, or are going to be commentating on you, I'm not going to be doing the whole, I suggest that you retire, because like what Sir Raven said, if you do enjoy making commentaries, no matter on how much commentaries there are on you that you get from the commentary community, then keep making commentaries. I'm not really forcing anyone to quit on what they love doing, unless if they've done something horrible. Mr. Cool Guy. However, I do think that you do need some help with making them. I suggest that you should get about 3 people who do know the subject, not just 3 random people, and have them read the script for you and proofread them. I've shown my script towards many other commentators as well as my sister Blano Taku, so don't be afraid to ask for help. And if you do have someone to read your script, then I suggest that you get more people to read them.
My final thoughts for this commentary, MD, we are extremely disappointed with you. We are sad to say that this commentary did not do you any justice at all. You repeat the same points and having a triple feature is completely unnecessary. Hush, woman, I have spoken. Nah, JK, I love you.